In this video, we are going to see the OSI model in computer networking. OSI stands for Open Systems Interconnection. It has been developed by the ISO, that is the International Organization of Standardization, in the year 1984. It is a reference model that describes how information from a software application in one computer moves through a physical medium to the software application in another computer. This is the picture of the OSI model, where it has seven layers: physical, data link, network, transport, session, presentation, and the application. And the information from the sender crosses all these seven layers and it reaches the receiver. We are going to see layer by layer and also the form of data or information in the particular layer, and also the functionalities of each layer. First, we move to the physical layer, which is the lowest layer of the OSI reference model, and this layer is responsible for the actual physical connection between the devices. The physical layer contains information in the form of bits. It is responsible for transmitting individual bits from one node to the next. When receiving the data, that is at the receiver's end, this layer will get the signals received, and then it converts the signals into zeros and ones, and then it sends the zeros and ones to the data link layer, which will put the frame back together. That we will see in the next when we see the next layer. Then the physical layer establishes, maintains, and deactivates the physical connection when transmitting the bits from one node to the next, that is from the sender to the receiver. Next, we move to the data link layer, which is the second layer. This layer takes the packets from the network layer and encapsulates them into frames. This encapsulation is nothing but adding header and trailer to the data. Then it sends, then this layer sends each frame bit by bit on the hardware of the particular machine. At the receiver's end, the data link layer picks up the signals, that is the zeros and ones, from the hardware and assembles them back into frames. We can see the structure of the frame. This structure in the picture, the structure of the frame has a header, payload field, and trailer, where the frame header contains the source and destination address of the frame, and the payload field contains the message that is to be delivered, and the trailer contains the error detection and error correction bits. Next, we move to the third layer, which is the network layer. This works, or it has, the network layer has its part for the transmission of data from one host to other, located in different networks. The network layer is implemented by networking devices such as routers. This receives the transport, that is, this network layer receives the transport layer segments and add a network layer header or label to create a packet. The header must contain the address of the host to which it is being sent, and also contains the address of the originating host. When the packet arrives at the destination host, that is at the receiver's side, when the packet arrives, the network layer in the receiver side examines the destination address to verify that the packet was addressed to this particular device or not. If it is correct, that packet is decapsulated, and that is the addition of header is removed or decapsulated, and the segment contained in the packet is passed up to the transport layer. We move to the fourth layer, which is the transport layer. When the data arrives at the transport layer from the upper layers, it is divided into segments, where each segment is assigned a header which contains a sequence number. This sequence number allows the transport layer on the destination or at the receiving host to reassemble the segments in the order in which they were transmitted. This is the functionality of the transport layer at the receivers and also in the sender's side. Next, we move to this fifth layer, which is the session layer. This layer provides the mechanism for opening, closing, and managing a session between two end-user application processes, where sessions are nothing but requests and responses that occur between applications. This layer is also responsible for authorizing and authenticating a session between two end-user applications, where authentication is nothing but before establishing a session with some network peer or a computer, it is important for one of the computers to know the other to which it is communicating is a legitimate one or not. Then authorization is like, are you authorized to do so, or are you the authorized person to communicate? You can say. Next, we move to the sixth layer, which is the presentation layer. This is also called as the translation layer, since the data from the application layer, which is the layer above this presentation layer, is extracted here and manipulated as per the record format which is needed to transmit over the network. This layer is an important layer in the OSI model because it is responsible for important services like data compression, encryption, and decryption. Then we move to the last layer, which is the application layer, or you can say the layer 7. This is implemented by the network applications. These applications produce the data that has to be transferred over the network. This also serves as the window for application services to access the network and for displaying the received information to the user. Example, browsers, Skype, Messenger, etc. Where these are the applications we use to generate a message or send the message to others. This application layer is also called as the desktop layer. Subscribe to this channel In and Around Computer if you feel contented.